So guys, today we discuss the third part, which is major part of the application of derivative, which is Rolle's theorem and Lagrange's mean value theorem. So here, Rolle's theorem and Lagrange's mean value theorem, which is also called as LMVT, gives some conditions to for to satisfy it. First we take Rolle's theorem. The conditions of Rolle's theorem, if we satisfy some conditions, then we can prove the Rolle's theorem. First, we can say that in the Rolle's theorem, if function f is polynomial function, and a given function y is equals to f of x is in the form of y is equals to f of x, then there some conditions are given. If this condition we can satisfy, then we can prove the Rolle's theorem. The first condition in that, f is continuous on close interval ab. The first condition of Rolle's theorem is f is continuous on closed interval of ab. A second condition of Rolle's theorem, then again f is differentiable on open interval a comma b. Here a be a x coordinate of the given functions, y be a, b be a y coordinate, means a comma this point which is lie on a comma f of a. After that, third condition, when the f is polynomial function in form of y is equals to f of x, and f is continuous on closed interval a b, and f is differentiable on open interval a b, then f of a is equals to f of b. Then there exists, at least one point C, and C belongs to A comma B, such that F dash of C is equals to 0, or we can find the value of C which lie on the interval A comma B. Here point C exists in A comma B, so it is clear that when the both functions f of a is equals to f of b, then there exists at least one point c, and c belongs to a comma b, such that f dash of c is equals to 0. These conditions, by using this condition, we can verify or we can prove Rolle's theorem. So we can write here the statement of Rolle's theorem. What is the statement of Rolle's theorem? We can say that if y is equals to f of x be a polynomial function, and f is continuous on closed interval AB, and again f is differentiable on open interval AB. So here again we can say that if y is equals to f of x be a polynomial function, and f is continuous on closed interval AB, and f is differentiable on open interval AB, then there exists at least one point, that point we can consider that C, and C is belongs to, C is related to, we can say other, C is belongs to or C is related to A comma B, such that f dash of C is equals to 0. we can prove this Rolle's theorem by using some geometrical interpretation. So we can say that on the coordinate axis, which is y axis, x axis, and here if one of the curve which is and in this curve one line is passing through this curve, the coordinate of x axis are same, a comma f of a. Here again the coordinate of this point P2, which is again a comma f of b. So here the value of a, which is on x coordinate, are equal. Hence we can say that which is point P, here distance from A, we can say that A, B, C, the intersection of both coordinate axes, which is origin. So here we can say that the value of F of A and value of F of B are equal. So again, on a coordinate axis, x axis, y axis, the curve which lying parallel to x axis and the distance of this line a comma f of a, again distance of point P to a comma f of b, here a, b, c, which is origin. Here again we can say that the x coordinate, both line, distance of both line are equal, hence coordinate are equal, then we can say that f of a is equals to f of b exist. Hence here we can say that point C, which lie in the interval in between point A and point B, so which is a function A f of A, we can say that f of B, and we can say that f of C, such that there f dash of C is exist and the value of f dash of C is 0. Hence we can say that here C belongs to A comma B. Again here we can say that the distance of this function, which is f of A, which is f of B, f of C, and C belong, C which lie in between A comma B, such that we can say that A comma B or C belongs to the point C, which is C belongs to A comma B. Here at least one point C belongs to A comma B, such that f dash of C is equals to 0. Again we can say that on coordinate axis X, here the point which lie on x axis, distance between this point f of a and f of b are again equal. So the given example, which is related to Rolle's theorem, and here it is clear that we have to check whether the conditions of Rolle's theorem are satisfied. The following function, it means that the given function is in the form of f of x is equals to 2x cube minus 5x square plus 3x plus 2, and here the variable which is x is belongs to the value of x, any value of x which is belongs to in between 0 and 3. Belongs to means related to, or we can say that the value of x which is lie in between 0 and 3 by 2. So here if we have to check the condition of Rolle's theorem are satisfied or not, then we know that about conditions of Rolle's theorem. The first condition of Rolle's theorem, which is if the given function f is polynomial function, then f is continuous on closed interval a comma b, and y is differentiable on open interval a comma b. Then there exists at point 0 x coordinate, which is a, consider 3 by 2 on y coordinate, which is b, then f of a is equals to f of b. So we can, if we have to prove this function, f of x is equals to 2x cube minus 5x square plus 3x plus 2 is a satisfied the condition of Rolle's theorem, then first we can consider, let R given that f of x is given, given that f of x is equals to 2x cube minus 5x square plus 3x plus 2 be a polynomial function, be a polynomial function. We can say that this equation number 1, the given function f of x is equal to 2x cube minus 5x square plus 3x plus 2 be a polynomial function, and it is continuous on closed interval AB and differentiable on open interval AB. It means that the value of A and B differentiable on here A comma B. So here coordinate A is 0, B is 3 comma 2. So we can say that A is equals to 0 and B is equals to 3 by 2. If the given function satisfies the condition f of A is equals to f of B, then we can say that it satisfies all the conditions of Rolle's theorem. So we can check that the value of f of A and value of f of B. So the value of f of A, when A is equals to 0, we can write f of 0, and the value of x, which is 0, we can write 2 into 0 cube minus 5 into 0 square plus 3 into 0 plus 2. Here 2 into 0 cube, which is 2 into 0 minus 5 into 0 square, 0 plus 3 into 0, 0 plus 2. 2 into 0, which is 0 minus 5 into 0, 0 plus 3 into 0, again 0 plus 2. We can say that 2, which is a number 2. So we have to check again the value of f of b. If the value of f of a and f of b are equals, then we can say that it satisfied all the conditions of Rolle's theorem. So again f of b is equals to f of b, the value of b, which is 3 by 2, f of 3 by 2 is equals to 2 into 3 by 2 whole bracket square, sorry, cube minus 5 into 3 by 2 whole bracket square plus 3 into 3 by 2 plus 2. So here the cube of 3 by 2, which is 27 by 8, minus 5 into the square of 3, which is 9 by 4, plus 3 into 3, 9 by 2 plus 2. Here 2 is 1, 8, 4, 27 by 4, minus 45 by 4, plus 18 by 4, plus 8 by 4. If we have to equal all denominator, we can write 27 minus 45 plus 18 plus 8 of 1 of 4. Denominators are equal. So here 45, 27 plus 18 plus 8 is, so minus 45 plus 26 is minus 19, and 27 minus 19, which is 8 by 4. The value of 8 by 4, which is f of b, is 2. Again, from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, we can say that the value of f of a and f of b are equal, means 2, f of a is equals to f of b is equals to 2. Then we can say that a means 0 and b means 3 by 2. F of 0 is equals to f of 3 by 2 are again equal, which is the value of 2. Hence we can say that it satisfied और द गिवन फंक्शन सेटिस्फाइड ऑल द कंडीशन ऑफ रोलीज थ्योरम।
सो अगेन हियर वी हैव टू चेक द गिवन फंक्शन सेटिस्फाइड द कंडीशन ऑफ रोलीज थ्योरम और नॉट। इफ वी हैव टू चेक the conditions of Rolle's theorem, the first condition of Rolle's theorem, which is the given function f is polynomial function and it is continuous on closed interval a comma b, if it exists, then again second condition, which is the given function f is polynomial function and it is differentiable on open interval a b, it again exists, then we can say that the value of f of a and the value of f of b are equal, it exists, then we can say here it satisfied or the given function is satisfied all the conditions of Rolle's theorem. So first we take the given function f of x is equals to x square minus 2x plus 3, which we give equation number first, is a polynomial function, and it is continuous on closed interval a comma b, then or and f is differentiable on open interval a comma b and a comma b is represented by 1 comma 4, then a is equals to 1 and b is equals to 4. So we can find the value of function which is in the form of f of a and when a is equals to 1, f of b when b is equals to 4. So first we have to find the value of f of a when a is equals to 1, which is the value of x replaced by 1 square minus 2 into 1 plus 3, 1 square minus 1 minus 2 plus 3, 1 minus 2 minus 1 plus 3, which is 2, example equation number 2. So the value of f of a is 2. Again we have to find the value of f of b when b is equals to 4. The value of f of b when b is equals to 4, again we have to find the value of f of 4. So here we can write the value of f of 4 when x is equals to 4, which is 4 square minus 2 into 4 plus 3, 4 square which is 16, minus 2 into 4 which is 8 plus 3, minus 8 plus 3, we can write 16 minus 5, which is 11, number 2. From equation 1 and 2, we can consider that from 1 and 2, the right hand side of the both equation, the equation of value of f of a is 2 and the value of f of b is 11. There, hence we can say that from equation 1 and 2, f of a is not equals to f of b. Hence we can say that another way, f of 1 is not equals to f of 4. So hence we can say that given function, or we can write this function y is equals to x square minus 2x plus 3, does not satisfied all the condition of Rolle's theorem. Here we check that the given function, which is example number second, f of x is x square minus 2x plus 3 at point 1 comma 4, does not satisfy all the condition of Rolle's theorem. So here in this example number 2, we have to verify Rolle's theorem. So if we have to verify the Rolle's theorem at any function, first we have to check the availability of given function which satisfied all the conditions of Rolle's theorem. Hence we can check first the given function f of x, x square minus 4x plus 10, be satisfied all the conditions of Rolle's theorem or not. So here, first we take given function f of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 10. So here we have to verify the Rolle's theorem at any points which c is belongs to 0, 4, such that at the condition of f dash of c is equals to 0. So first we check the given functions are satisfied the conditions of Rolle's theorem or not. The given function f of x, x square minus 4x plus 10 is a polynomial function and so we can say that the function f is a polynomial function and it is continuous on closed interval a comma b, or we can write 0, 4, and again it is differentiable on open interval 0, 4, so that we have to find the value of f of 0 or f of 4 when a is equals to 0 and b is equals to 4. First we have to find the value of f of a, which is the value of a when 0. We can write this coordinate x replaced by 0 square minus 4 into 0 plus 10. 0 square 0 minus 0 plus 10, we can write 10 number 2. So here equation number 1. Again, if we have to find, check the conditions of Rolle's theorem, our given function is satisfied or not, then again we have to find the value of f of b. If the value of f of a and f of b are equal, then we can say that the given function f of x is satisfied all the conditions of Rolle's theorem. So, the b value of b, which is 4, we can write it 4 square minus 4 into 4 plus 10, 4 square which is 16. Minus 4 into 4 again, 16 plus 10, plus 16 minus 16 get cancelled, which is remain 0. 0 plus 10 again 10, which is equation number 3. So, from 2 and 3, we can say that right hand side of the value f of a and right hand side of equation 2, which is f of b, are equal, then we can say that the value of f of a is equals to f of b. That is, we can say that another way, f of 0 is equals to f of 4. Hence, function f is satisfied all the condition of Rolle's theorem. But here we have to find or we have to verify that the Rolle's theorem. If we have to verify the Rolle's theorem at any point C, then we consider that to get the value of C, such that we know that the value of C, which we should have, such that f dash of c is equals to 0 and this c is belongs to or c is related to in between 0, 4. C belongs to open interval 0, 4. It means that the value of c is not exactly 0, greater than 0, and is not exactly 4, less than 4. Hence we have to find here the value of f dash of c. By using this equation, f dash of c is equals to 0, we have to find the value of c. And when c lies in between 0 and 4, then we can say that we verify the Rolle's theorem. So, equation 1, which is f of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 10. And if we differentiate a given function, with respect to x, then we take a derivative of f of x is f dash of x. Derivative of x square is 2x minus 4 into derivative of x is 1 and the derivative of 10 which is 0. So here 2x minus 4 which is the value of f dash of x. But we have to find the value of f dash of c. Here we get the value of c if we replace x at c, then we can write f dash of c is equals to 2c minus 4. But we have to know that f dash of c is equals to 0. Hence we can write, replacing f dash of c is 0, we can write 2c minus 4 is equals to 0. 2c is equals to minus 4, we can get 4. C is equals to 4 by 2 which is 1 by 2. And this value of 1 by 2 is really in between 0 and 4, means value of 1 by 2 which is 0.5, which is greater than 0 and less than 4. Hence we can write that 1 by 2 belongs to 0 comma 4. Hence we can write here Rolle's theorems are verified. Here we can write one statement. Hence Rolle's theorem are verified. So the next one, which is example number 3, given an interval which is a comma b that satisfied hypothesis of Rolle's theorem for the function f of x is equals to x cube minus 2x square plus 3. If it is known that a is equals to 0, then we have to find the value of b. The minimum value of a is 0. So it is clear that when the value of a is 0, then we have to find the value of b. First we take given a function f of x is equals to x cube minus 2x square plus 3 b of polynomial function, which is given function is a polynomial function. If the given function is polynomial function, then it is continuous on closed interval a comma b when a is equals to 0, and differentiable on open interval ab when a is equals to 0, then we have to find the value of b, which is what? So here when a is equals, it is clear that first we consider that equation 1 become, so let these two functions, which is x cube minus 2x square, let g of x is equals to x cube minus 2x cube, or we can write directly given function f of x is equals to x cube minus 2x square plus 3. And if we put the value of a which is 0, then we can say that at x is equals to a is equals to 0, the value of f of 0, which is 0 cube minus 2 into 0 square plus 3. 0 cube means 0 minus 0 plus 3, the value of f of 0, which is 3, equation number 2. So if the functions f of a and f of b are equal, then we can say that it satisfied all the conditions of Rolle's theorem. And if we observe the value of b, which is 2, again if we put the value of x and the value of x is equals to 2, then we can say that the value of b is again 2, and the value of f of b, which is f of 2, is 2 cube minus 2 into 2 square plus 3. 2 cube is 8 minus 8 plus 3 plus 8 minus 8 become cancel, get cancelled, is 0 plus 3, again 3, which is the value of f of b, number 3. If we observe that equation 2 and equation 3, we can say that from equation 2 and 3, f of a is equals to f of b. That is, we can say that f of value of a, which is 0, and f of b, value of b, which is 2. Hence, we can say that it satisfied all the condition of Rolle's theorem at a comma b represented by 0, 2. Hence, if a is equals to 0, then the value of b is 2. The required value of b is 2. So here, in example number 4, we have to verify that Rolle's theorem. If we have to verify the Rolle's theorem, first we have to check that the given function is satisfied all the conditions of Rolle's theorem or not. So after that, we can say that the given function at any point, we consider that point C, is lies in between pi by 4 and 5 by 4, by using the condition or such that f dash of c is equals to 0. So first we have to check the given function f of x equals to e to the power x into sin x minus cos x is satisfied all the conditions of Rolle's theorem or not. First we consider that given a function f of x is equals to e to the power x sin x minus cos x be a polynomial function and it is continuous on closed interval a means pi by 4 and b means 5 pi by 4, and differentiable on open interval pi by 4 and 5 pi by 4. So here we can say that the value of a is pi by 4 and b is 5 pi by 4. So we have to find the value of f of a is equals to f of pi by 4. We replace the value of x, which is pi by 4. We can write e to the power pi by 4 into sin pi by 4 minus cos pi by 4. We know that the value of sin pi by 4, which is 1 by root 2, and value of cos pi by 4 is again 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2, 0. E to the power pi by 4 into 0, we can write 0. The value of f of a is 0, equation number 1 or equation number 2. So here, again we have to find the value of b. When b is equals to 5 pi by 4, we can write f of b is equals to f of 5 pi by 4. And the value of f of pi by 4, which is e to the power 5 pi by 4 into sine of 5 pi by 4 minus cos of 5 pi by 4. Again, we can say that e to the power 5 pi by 4, the value of sine pi by 4, which is minus 1 by root 2, and value of cos of 5 pi by 4 again minus 1 by root 2. So here we can write e to the power 5 pi by 4 into minus 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2, both get cancelled, which is 0. E to the power 5 pi by 4 into 0, we can write 0. The value of f of b again is 0. From 1 and 2, we can say that f of a is equals to f of b. That is, we can write the value of a where the pi by 4, value of pi by 4 is equals to f of 5 pi by 4. So, it satisfies all the condition of Rolle's theorem if it exists any point C such that f dash of C is equals to 0 at C belongs to A comma B or C belongs to pi by 4 comma 5 pi by 4. So here we have to find the value of f dash of C. So we first take the equation 1 become here, the equation 1 become here, we can write again equation A become, and the equation A is f of x is equals to e to the power x sin x minus cos x, and if we differentiate the given function with respect to x, then we get the derivative of f of x, which is f dash of x. So if we differentiate with respect to x, then the derivative of f of x, which is f dash of x. By using the rules of u into v, we can differentiate e to the power x into derivative of sin x minus cos x plus sin x minus cos x into derivative of e to the power x. So here e to the power x as it is, sin x, derivative of sin x, which is the cos x minus minus plus the derivative of cos x minus sin x, which is sin x. So again plus sin x minus cos x as it is, and the derivative of e to the power x is e to the power x. So here derivative of sin x, which is cos x, derivative of cos x, which is minus sin x. If we take the e to the power x common from both term, we can write e to the power x into cos x plus sin x plus sin x minus cos x. Here cos x plus cos x minus sin x, cos x get cancelled. E to the power x into 2 sin x. We can write that 2 e to the power x into sin x, which is the value of f dash of x. So if we replace the value of x is c, then we can say that f dash of c is equals to 2 e to the power x into sin x, and the value of f dash of c is 0. So we can write 2 into e to the power x into sin x is equals to 0. If we shift this 2 into e to the power x right side, then we can say that again the value of sin x is also 0. It is possible that when sin x is equal to 0, when the value of x is 0, because sin 0 is 0, value of x is pi, sin pi is also 0, sin value of x is 2 pi, when sin 2 pi is also 0, sin of 3 pi is 0, sin is 4 pi is 0, sin is 5 pi is equal to 0, up to n. So hence we can write the value of x is 0 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, 5 pi, and this value of 0 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, here the value which is pi and 2 pi lies in between pi by 4 and 2 pi. Here therefore pi belongs to pi by 4 and 5 pi by 4, and again second 2 pi belongs to pi by 4 and 5 pi by 4. Both the value which is pi and 2 pi are related to pi by 4 and 5 pi by 4. Hence we can say that conditions of Rolle's theorem are satisfied, or Rolle's theorem are verified. So in the next lecture we have to show the Lagrange's mean value theorem and some examples which on it. After that we take exercise number 2.3, and 2.3 is depend on Rolle's theorem and Lagrange's mean value theorem both. So in the next lecture, first we take Lagrange's mean value theorem. After that, we take exercise 2.3, which is depend on Rolle's theorem and Lagrange's mean value theorem.